Hello everyone. Welcome to Virtual Raps. This is the first video I'm publishing for the cell about cell physiology and cell structure and cell functions, like the basic chapter for the cell chapter. So this is mainly helpful for the medical students and for the class. Cell physiology. Mainly we can see here is a human physiology. Okay. Physio is a nature, logy means is a study. Study of the nature, the human body. Okay, the nature of the sense we are what we are using the natural means the different levels of our worker functions like our body. Okay. So mainly then physiology focusing on our body functions and the structures at different levels. Okay. So cell, it will come from the cell, it's a living thing, is composed of the cells. Okay. For example, we are all, it's made up of million or trillion number of group of cells only we are sitting here. So it's a main role for them, our body, the cell. Okay, a single cell is the smallest unit that has all the characteristics of life. So, cell is defined as a structural and functional unit of the living body. Can you see here, for example, it should be cell, it should be single. Okay, it should be how it will goes to next level. It should be tissue. Next level, it will be number of cells is together, it will work, it will be a similar function, it will be tissues. You can see here, it will be number of cells having a similar function, or it's a different, it's a group of cells. Cells having a similar function, it will be tissue we called. Okay, so tissue, it's a major function. Together cells only it will be doing. Okay, so what are the major or primary types of tissues is there? Can I see four types is there? One for muscular tissue, one for nervous tissue, one for epithelial tissue, one for connective tissues. Okay, muscle tissue is major role for the muscular system, and nerve tissue is mainly it's formed for the nervous system, and epithelial tissue is formed by our skin system. Skin, okay, dermis like this, epithelial layer and everything, okay. Then connective tissue is a blood and circulatory system. Okay, it should be major tissues are working different. Primary tissues we are called here. Okay. Then next we'll go for cell and tissue, then next we'll go for organ. So, group or one or more tissue, primary tissues are together same functions which work together, that's we call for organ. Okay, for example, group of this all inside we can see visible, it should be cells, it's cells, it should together work, we call for tissue. So, tissues, it should be together, it should be work, we call for organ. Okay. Then the organ is a structure and structural that has formed by the two or more primary types of tissues. What are the primary type tissues? First we seen that muscular tissue and epithelial tissue, nervous tissue and connective tissue. These are the four primary tissues there. So here these two or more primary tissues, it should be formed from one organ. Okay, so next we go for types of organ. It's a two types is a major, tubular or hollow organ, or compact or parenchymal organ. Okay, now we come for the system. Same like group of organ is together working for similar function, specific also same kind of function, that we call for system. Specific for the defined as a group of organs that work together to carry out a specific function of the body. Okay, each system performing the specific functions. For example, you can see here last we are discussing about the organ, okay? You can just imagine these all it will be organ, okay? It should be group of organ together, it should be work. Finally, we call this is entire things we call for system, okay? For example, digestive system we are taking. Digestive, we can, it will be digest the food particle, it will be mouth, we go for the food and come to destroy. Entire thing we call for digestive system. So it should be one process, food, it will be digestion protocol. This is a major role, but it should be working so many organs together. That's we call for digestive system. Like a excretory system, it will be waste, unwanted substance will be wasting. Like blood system, it will be circulation, it will be formed and circulating, like that. So group of organs work together, the same functions, that we call for system. Now we go for the cell. Cell, we can see how it will be work major role for the next level. Now we'll go for the deeper cell. Now we'll come for structure of the cells. Okay, so each cells formed by cell body and cell membrane, and it should be there inside. Okay, so cell body or cell and cell membrane is covering entire things which called for cell membrane or covering layer, whatever like that. Okay, it should be called like that, cell membrane. Okay, so cell membrane, inside what is there? Inside major, it's a nucleus. Surrounding the nucleus and cell membrane, in between it will be cytoplasm, which it's like a fluid and jelly like structure is there. Okay, the major is there. Okay, can I see? It should be there, it should be entire surrounding, it will be cell membrane. So inside it will be nucleus is there, then you can see nucleus and cell membrane, in between it should be there, everything, it should be jelly like structure, it will become cytoplasm. Okay, now we'll go for cell membrane. Cell membrane is a protective sheath. Actually it should be protective sheath and enveloping the cell body. It's also known as the plasma lemma and the plasma membrane, which two call name is there. So this membrane separate from the fluid outside of the cell and inside of the cell. Outside of the cell we are called for extracellular fluid, inside of the cell we are called for intracellular fluid. So in between separating layer, that is the main role for the cell membrane. Okay, so okay, then composition of the cell membrane, what are the composition? You can see here it will be protein and lipid and carbohydrate. The three things is a major form for the substance in the cell membrane. Okay, that structure of the cell membrane, on the basic of the structure of cell membrane is called for unit membrane or the three layered membrane. We're telling three layered membrane, the means three layer is there. First layer, it should be protein layer, then second is the lipid layer, then again it should be third also, it should be protein. This is the three layer will formed, that's we call for three layered membrane or unit membrane. Okay, the two which two electron dense layer we call for protein layer, it should be in between, send in between, it should be lipid layer, that we call for center layer. Okay, then protein layer formed by proteins and lipid layer formed by lipids. You can see it will be entire cell, center it will be nucleus is there, and the nucleus and cell membrane in between, cytoplasm also is there. So the outer of the cell fluid we call for extracellular, inside of the fluid it is intracellular fluid. Okay, so we can zoom the cell membrane, you can see it will be red color, this is by the protein layer, the yellow color is a lipid layer, then again the bottom also it will be protein layer. Okay, this is the three layered membrane. Okay, and this is the main thing, we call lipid layer. We taken the lipid layer. It should be phospholipid bilayer. We called actually bilayer means it should be lipid two layer is there in between. Let's see the next lipid layer. Lipid layer of the cell, it should be bilayered structure. I told you there is, these are the formed by thin film lipids, thin film lipids. Okay, this characteristic of the fluid layer is that fluid of the nature, not for solid structure here. Okay, so portion of the cell membrane move from the one point to another point along the surface of the cell. So the material dissolved, the lipid layers also move to all areas of the cell membrane. The major role of the lipid layer, it should be, you can see the substance for phospholipids and cholesterol. Phospholipids, okay, let's see here. Phospholipids, it will be there inside the yellow color. Okay, so phospholipids, it's made for two layer, we're telling, right? It's a bilayered. Can see here, it should be one phospholipid and another phospholipid, like parallelly it should be arranging. So each phospholipid having a hydrophilic head and hydrophilic tail. Okay, next we'll go for the protein layer. Protein layers of the cell membrane, it's integral proteins or transmembrane proteins, and peripheral proteins are peripheral membrane protein. We'll go back, we'll see here. It will be integral protein or is the transport proteins. One is the, because the both it will be connected. Then peripheral protein, it's a surface protein. It is only connected to this, either surface here or top, like that only. Okay. Then functions of the cell membrane. What are the function main for the productive function? Cell membrane is a product, the cytoplasm of granules. Granules is the inside of this, so, okay, organelles. The two is a main productive functions of cell membrane. Then selective permeability. Selective permeability means it's a cell membrane, it act like a semi-permeable membrane. Means it should be allow for what is the necessary things, that only it should be allow for inside, what unwanted thing it should be executed from the outside, like it will selective. It should be what are the things it should be observed, what are the things not observed, like there should be permitting, selective permeability. Okay, it is sometimes like a barrier, it should be working. Then next function is absorption function. It will be main major role for the absorption of the nutrition through the cell membrane. Okay, then executory function, like how it will be nutrition will be absorbing, like it will be waste content or waste product, it will be excreted from the same cell membrane. Okay, then exchange of the gas for oxygen will be absorbing, and carbon dioxide will be exit, like that it should be gas exchanges also, it should be major role for the cell membrane, it should be functions. And maintenance of the cell size. Cell size also should be responsible to maintain for the cell membrane. Okay, then cytoplasm. Cytoplasm of the cell, cytoplasm already we are telling is a jelly like water structure. It's a 80% of the water. It contains, it's a clear liquid and portion we call for cytosol. Can see a cytosol. Then various particles of the different shapes and size. These particles are made for the protein, carbohydrate and lipids or electrolytes in the nature. Okay, then cytoplasm we divided for two types or two names. We are telling ectoplasm and endoplasm. Endoplasm is a inner part of the interposed between the ectoplasm to and nucleus. Ectoplasm is a situated from the peripheral, means it's outside beneath the cell membrane. That plasm, okay. Then organelles with limiting membrane. Then organelles without limiting membrane. It's a cytoplasmic organ. organelles, which will become for two divided major roles. Okay, we'll see here, it should be organelles with limiting membrane for endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi apparatus and lysosomes and periosteum and centrosome and centroles and secretory vessels and mitochondria and nucleus. These all under it will be organelles with limiting membrane. Then organelles without limiting membrane, it should be ribosome and cytoskeleton. You can see all this endoplasmic reticulum here between nucleus and cytoplasm and cytoskeleton and ribosome, it should be daughter, it should be ribosome, then mitochondria, then lysosome, then Golgi body. Then granules with limiting membrane, we just see now. The first one is the endoplasmic reticulum. We can see endoplasmic reticulum is a network of tubular and microsomal vascular structure. We call it will be like a inner connection. It will be the network like interconnect with the one another. It will be connecting. So it's covered a limiting membrane, which is formed by proteins and bilayered lipids. Okay, the main functions of rough endoplasmic reticulum is a synthesis of protein. It means it's a breakdown of the proteins. It should be work synthesis. Okay, then degradation of the worn out granules. Then you can see here it will be everything it will be connecting, right? But this will be called for network, internet, it will be connecting like structures. Okay. Next, it should be smooth and rough. Smooth, it should be outer it is nearest to nucleus, it should be rough endoplasmic reticulum will be there, and little far it should be smooth endoplasmic reticulum is there. Okay, first we are seeing its rough endoplasmic reticulum, it's a two function. What we are doing for synthesis of protein and degradation of worn out granules. Okay. Then smooth endoplasmic reticulum is endoplasmic reticulum with smooth appearance will be there. That's we call for like this. Okay. And it also it's formed by many interconnected tubules. So it also is called for tubular endoplasmic reticulum. Functions of the smooth endoplasmic reticulum means we can see non-protein substance. First, rough endoplasmic reticulum is a synthesis of protein. Okay, this is synthesis of non-protein substance. Then role of cellular metabolism outer surface of smooth endoplasmic reticulum. It should be contain many enzymes involving in various metabolic processes of the cells. Okay, then storage of metabolism of the calcium. Main role is there, storage of metabolism of calcium. Smooth endoplasmic reticulum is a major site storage of metabolism of calcium. The cell where it will be storage of calcium is mean smooth endoplasmic reticulum. There is a part it will be storage of calcium. Okay, then catabolism is a detoxification of smooth endoplasmic reticulum is also concerned with catabolism and toxic substance like some drugs or carcinogen for cancer producing substance in liver, like it should be work. Okay, next we'll go further. This is telling it will be endoplasmic reticulum. Then we'll go for Golgi complex. Golgi complex or Golgi apparatus, it will be same name only. Golgi apparatus or Golgi body or Golgi complex, which are membrane bound in the organelles involved in the processing of protein. Okay. It is present in all the cells except in the red blood cells. We can major role, you can see Golgi apparatus is a absence where it will be red blood cells. RBC, it will be not there for Golgi apparatus. Then each Golgi apparatus consists of the 5 to 8 flattened membrane sacs we call for cistern. Okay. You can see it will be 5 to 8 sacs will be there like a folding. That we call for cistern. Okay. Golgi apparatus is situated for near the nucleus. It has also end or phases we are telling, namely cis phase and trans phase, the two end we are telling for near end and far end we are telling, like you can see here trans phase and cis phase. This is cis phase, this is a trans phase. In between the folding layer, we can see these are the cistern. Okay. So, okay, what is this function? Functions of the Golgi apparatus. Okay, processing of materials. Processing of materials, vessels containing Golgi proteins and lipids are transported into Golgi apparatus. Here the glycoproteins. Okay, processing of the materials and lipids modified in the processing. That is a major role. First function. Okay, then second is packaging. Packaging of the materials. First, it should be processed and it he made for the glycoprotein to modify to lipid like that. So, next is packaging materials. What is it doing for all the process of processed materials are packed from the like secretory granules or secretory vesicles or lysosome, which are transported either out of the cell or to another out of the cell or to another part of the cell. We need right. So it should be like packaging. So this we called for Golgi apparatus. This processing we nickname for the post office of the cell. That is the real we are calling for post office of the cells. Okay, then labeling on delivering the materials. Okay, we already processing the material, then we are packaging also the materials, then we are going to labeling and delivering the materials. We are telling. So, Golgi apparatus is shot out of the processed and packaged materials and labeled. Okay, then labels mean it should be the identified. This is the material for this item like this, it will be made. For chemical content for the delivery, the proper destination where this need to go, where this need to go like that. So that's work is that work the organs doing. So we call for shipping department of the cells also. Okay. Then lysosome. Lysosome is a membrane bound the vascular organs found throughout the cytoplasm will be there. Okay, throughout the first plasm, so the membrane is formed by the bilayered lipid material. It has many small granules which has contained hydrolytic enzymes. Contained enzyme, it should be what is there? And hydrolytic enzymes is there. So now next we'll go for the types of lysosome. Primary lysosomes and secondary lysosomes. The two types, primary lysosomes, which is pinched off from the Golgi apparatus, it has inactive in a spite having a hydrolytic enzymes. Then secondary lysosomes, which is the active lysosome, it's formed by the fusion of the primary lysosomes with phagosomes or endosomes like. So, lysosome are often called for the carry back systems of the cell because of their degradation of activities. Okay, degradation of macromolecules such as bacteria and end up in the cell via phagocytes. Telling for that phagocytosis are called phagosomes or macrophages. There are other macromolecules taken inside via pinocytosis or receptor mediated endosomes. We call for endosomes. Okay. Then degradation of worn out granules. अगर आप एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम रैप इटसेल्फ अराउंड द वॉर्म आउट ग्रैनल्स लाइक ए माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया ऑन फॉर्म पर वैक्यूल्स भी कर पर ऑटोफेगोस ओके देन लाइज रिमूवल ऑफ एक्सेस सेक्रेटरी प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ द सेल्स इट्स अ लाइसोसोम इन द सेल्स सेक्रेटरी ग्लैंड्स रिमूव एक्सेसिव सेक्रेटरी प्रोडक्ट्स बाय डिग्रेडेशन ऑफ सेक्रेटरी ग्रैनल्स ओके देन सेक्रेटरी फंक्शन सी इट बी लाइसोसोम हैविंग सेक्रेटरी फंक्शन द कॉल सेक्रेटरी लाइसोसोम्स आर फाउंड इन द सम ऑफ द सेल्स पर्टिकुलरली इन द इम्यून सिस्टम ओके देन पीरियोसोम्स आर माइक्रो बॉडीज आर द मेम्ब्रेन लिमिटिंग द वेसल्स लाइक लाइसोसोम्स पीरियोसोम्स कंटेन्स Some oxidative enzymes such as catalase, carburet oxidase, D-amino acid dioxide. It's a content of peroxisome. It's made the content inside. You can see it should be D-amino acid oxidase and urate oxidase and catalase. These are the enzymes. Then we go for the functions. What are the functions in peroxisome? Ribosomes, break down the fatty acid by means process we call for beta oxidation, which is breakdown of fatty acids. Then degrade the toxic substance, degrade this toxic substance, which means such as hydrogen peroxide and other metabolic product. So by means it's a deoxification, the work process name. Then oxygen utilization on the cells. This is a main peroxisome work for oxygen utilization on the cells. Now we'll see for the centrosome and centrioles. Centrosome is a membrane bound cellular granule situated from the, almost in center of the cell. You can see it should be zoom here. See, it will be nucleus. This is a nucleus. It will be rough endoplasmic. It will be mitochondria. Now you can see centrioles. Centrioles, like it's near only, will be there. Centrioles, And that's what we're telling. It should be center of the cell or close to the nucleus, consist of the two cylindrical structures we call for two cylindrical the structures we call for centrioles, which are made up of proteins. The centrioles are responsible for the movement of chromosomes during the cell division. These are the major things. This is the role, which is movement of the chromosomes during the cell divisions. Then secretory vesicles. Secretory vesicles. Secretory vesicles are the granules which limiting membrane and contain the secretory substance. These vesicles are formed in the endoplasmic reticulum. It's a process of packed Golgi apparatus. That time it also it should be together to be work for which secretory vesicles. And secretory vesicles are present throughout the cytoplasm. It should be how lysosomes are presenting throughout the surrounding the cytoplasm like that. Secretory vesicles also present throughout the cytoplasm. When necessary, these vesicles are ruptured in the secretory substance and released into the cytoplasm. Say endocytosis and exocytosis. Endocytosis, it should be inside, it should be going, visit in the endosome. Then secretory vesicle, it should be going for exocytosis, means you're going through for outside. It should be cell membrane, it should be carried inside, it should be entire cell, it will be going inside endosome, then it will go for exocyte. Now next we'll go for the mitochondria. We'll see the mitochondria. It's a plural. It's a mitochondria also we are telling or as product energy or power storage. It's so many called they're telling. which membrane of Bayh is also membrane bound cytoplasmic granules concerned with the production of energy. Okay, it is a rod shaped or oval shaped structure, diameter 0.5 to 1 mu. It is covered by bilayered membrane, same like it's a bilayered membrane. Okay, and I see it will be outer membrane protein and inner membrane like that. Okay, then it will be there mitochondria DNA and matrix, we are telling matrix granule and ribosomes and ATP synthesis and intermembrane space. Okay, and then what are the functions of the mitochondria? Production of energy. This is the major function, production of energy. So this function mitochondria doing, so we call for powerhouse or power plant. Okay, of the cell. Okay, because of producing the energy required, the cellular function here. Okay. Next feature, synthesis of ATP. ATP actually synthesis. The component of the respiratory chain in mitochondria are responsible for the synthesis of ATP, utilizing the energy for oxidative phosphorylation. Okay. And storage of calcium and detoxification and ammonia in liver. Okay, storage. What is another major role? It will be storage of calcium and detoxification and ammonia in the liver. The first production of energy also. Then we'll see granules without limiting. Now we see entire it will be granules with limiting membrane. Now we come for granules without limiting membrane, ribosomes and cytoskeleton. Okay, ribosomes are the granules without limiting membrane. These granules are granular and small, dot-like. It will be dot-like, will be there. Structure diameter 15 nanometers. Okay. Types of ribosome, it will be ribosome and free ribosome. Like that. Ribosomes that are attached to rough endoplasmic reticulum. It should be near the nucleus, it should be there in the rough endoplasmic reticulum. There it should be attached to the ribosome. And three ribosomes that are distributed in the cytoplasm. Okay, two types. Now we'll come for the function of the ribosome. Okay, ribosomes are called for protein factory. We are called for protein factory for ribosome making because of their role in synthesis of the protein. Okay, and messenger RNA carries the genetic code protein synthesis from nucleus to the ribosome. Okay. We'll see here, which will become amino chain tRNA transferase, and then it will become again here, then again through to amino chain protein, which will be make. Okay, see, then next it will be cytoskeleton. Cytoskeleton, which cytoskeleton is the cellular organelles present throughout the cytoplasm. Okay, this also presenting in the cytoplasm. It determines the shapes and cell, gives support to the cells. Okay, and cytoskeleton is consisted of the three major protein is there, protein component. A cytoskeleton is made for microtubules and intermediate filaments and macrofilaments. It will see it will be complete. There microtubules and intermediate filaments and microfilaments. Okay. Then first you will see for microtubule. Microtubule is straight. See it will be straight, hollow, and tubular structure. The cytoskeleton. Each tubule has a diameter of 22-30 nanometers, and microtubules are formed by bundles of globular protein called for tubulin. Okay, Now, functions of the microtubules. Functions of microtubules determine the shape of the cell and give the structure and strength of the cell and act like a conveyor belt, which is allowed to movement of the granules, vesicles, protein, molecules, and some granules like mitochondria. It's a different part of the cells, okay? And form spindle fibers, which is separate the chromosomes and during the mitosis, okay, are responsible for the movements of centroids and the complex cellular structure like cilia. Then intermediate filaments, you can see intermediate filament, it will be micro filament, and this in between it should be there. Filament structure network around the nucleus and extend the periphery of the cells. You can return diameter of each filament, it's about for 10 mm. Okay. The intermediate filaments formed by a rope-like polymer. Okay, rope-like polymer, which are the made up of fibers protein only. So what is this function? Functions of the intermediate filament is a major role for the intermediate filament. Help to the maintain the shape of the cell. These filaments also connect the adjacent cells through the desmosomes. Okay. Microfilaments. This is the third one. Microfilaments are long and fine thread-like structure with area diameter of about 3 to 6 nm. Okay, these filaments are made up of non-tubular contractile protein called for actin and myosin. This is my major role. Microfilament, which will be act like what? Non-tubular contractile. That's tubular first one. Macro is a tubular, is a micro is a non-tubular. Okay. Now functions of microfilaments. Okay. Give structural strength and of the cell, same like provide the resistance of cell against the pulling. Against the cell, it will provide resistant force. Okay. Are responsible for cellular movement like contraction and gliding, cytokinesis movement. Next, we'll go for the nucleus. Okay, nucleus, it should be same like, it's the center of the cytoplasm situated, okay. And nucleolus, it's a center part, then outer layer, it should be nuclear pores also is there, walls like, and in between it should be chromosome is there. Okay, then its covering layer, we call for like nuclear membrane. Okay, nucleus is the most prominent and the largest cellular organelle. Diameter of 10 mu to 22 mu, occupying the 10% of the total volume of the cell. Okay. Now, the nucleus is present in the, all in our cell body except in the red blood cell. Okay. One more also will be absent in the red blood cell. If you remember, for the one more part also is absent by the red blood cells. If you know me, just comment it below. Like a nucleus. Which one is the except in the red blood cells situated, presenting, okay. These cells with nucleus are called eukaryotes, and those without nucleus are known as prokaryote, okay. Presence in the nucleus of the cell divisions. Nuclear membrane and nucleoplasm also inside. Nuclear membrane is outer layer of the nucleus. And this is formed by double layered. Or and then naturally, it's this allows to nucleoplasm to communicate with the cytoplasms. Okay, then nucleoplasm is surrounding the chromatin and the nucleus is there. Okay, which contain a dense fibrillar network of the proteins called for the nuclear matrix and many substances such as nucleotide and enzymes. The nuclear matrix forms in the structural framework for the granules chromatin. These soluble liquids are nucleoplasm is known as the nucleoidoplasm. Okay, we'll see the soluble liquid part of the nucleoplasm. It's also known for nuclear idoplasm. Next should be chromatin. Chromatin is a thread-like material made up of the large molecules of the DNA. The DNA molecules are compactly packed with the help of the specialized basic protein called for histone. Okay, so chromatin is referred as a DNA histone complex. Okay, DNA is a double helix which wrap around the central core of the 8 histone molecules form the fundamental packing unit. The chromatin called for nucleosome. Chromosomes are the rod-shaped nuclear structure that carries a complete blueprint of the all hereditary characteristic of the species. This is the main blueprint. Whatever you are doing, whatever some your next generation, this is everything is hereditary characteristic which will be carried. Okay. Normally, the chromosomes are not visible in the nucleus for them. Under microscopy also. Okay, only the cell division, the chromosomes are visible under microscope, but not all the time is visible. Okay, these cells are 23 pairs of the chromosomes, so are called for diploid cells. The reproductive cells are gametes or sex cells contain only 23 single chromosomes. Okay, these cells are called for haploid cells. Okay, nucleolus is a small round granular structure. It is structure of the nucleolus. Okay, each nucleus contain one or more nucleoli. Now we'll see for the functions of the nucleus. Control the all of the cell activities that include the metabolism, protein synthesis, growth and production, reproduction in cell division. Everything is controlling the nucleus. Synthesis of the RNA and formation of the subunit of the ribosomes and sending genetic instruction to the cytoplasm for protein synthesis through the messengers for the RNA. It's a mRNA we're telling, then controlling of the cell divisions through the gene. Now, it's for storage of hereditary information and transformation and the information from one generation to after splicing. Another, this is next level. This is the major role, which is nucleus. Okay. Now, deoxyribonucleic, we're telling DNA. Okay, deoxyribonucleic acid is a nucleic acid that carries the genetic information to offspring of the organism. Okay, DNA forms the chemical basis of the hereditary characteristic. You can see it will be cell and inside it will be nucleus. Now, chromosomes also inside is there, right? It will be chromosome. Inside the chromosome, you can see the DNA in the gene. So, okay, DNA, structure of the DNA. DNA is like a double standard complex nucleic acid. Okay, it's formed by deoxyribose and phosphoribic acid and four types of bases is there. Each DNA molecules consist of two polynucleotide chain which are twisted around one another in the form of double helix. You can see it will be double helix. It's a DNA actually. You will see it will be adenine, thymine, guanine, and cytosine. It will be like major A, T, G, C, we are telling. And major basic pair, then sugar, phosphate background. So each chain of DNA molecules like they are deoxyribose sugar and phosphate. One of the following organic nitrogenous bases, purines and bromines. Okay. Then guanine and thymine and cytosine, like a chain, like it will they made. These are all encoded. Hereditary information that is encoded in DNA is called for genome. Okay, now we'll go see what the gene. Gene is a portion of the DNA molecules contained a messenger or code of the synthesis of specific protein form of amino acid. Okay, it's like a book that contains enough information are necessary of the protein synthesis. Gene is considered as a basic hereditary unit of the cell. Okay, in the nucleotide of the DNA, three of successive base pair of together called a triplet of or a codon. Okay, this called when each codon codes or forms code word or information for one amino acid. For each word, it is formed for one amino acid. Okay, now RNA, ribonucleic acid. Ribonucleic acid is a nucleic acid that contains a long chain of the nucleotide units. It is similar to DNA but contains ribose instead of deoxyribose. That's it. The DNA it should be deoxyribose, RNA it should be ribose. That's it. Structure of these are the similar like structure of the RNA, it should be same like adenine, guanine. There it should be uracil and cytosine, it should be different. That's it. Because of there we can see it should be thymine. Here they are replacing by uracil. That's it. Almost it is similar like chain structure, it should be there. Then types of RNA is three types is there. Okay, it should be easy, it should be messenger RNA, it should be carrier, the genetic code, dendritic code of the amino acid. Okay, sequence of the synthesis of protein from the DNA to the cytoplasm. Okay, transfer RNA, then it should be responsible for the decoding the genetic messenger. First messenger RNA it will be transferred to genetic code. Transfer RNA it will be decoding the genetic message present mRNA. Okay, ribosomal RNA it will be present within the ribosome and forms a part of the structure of ribosome. Okay, it's responsible for the assembly of the proteins from the amino acid in the ribosome. Okay. Now, any questions or any doubts related in this topic, entire cell, okay, please comment below. Whenever I see, then I'll definitely reply. Thanks for your supporting. Thank you. We'll see you in the next chapter. Okay, bye.